Hey guys, check this out. I was playing around with the options. I was just kind of pushing random buttons. I'd seen this option on here, and I was like afraid to turn it on earlier because I thought it would tell me too much. I wanted to find these things myself, but artifact positions on. It'll only light them up on the map after you've already found them, by which I mean that the after your muon detector and the mapper has flown directly over the top of them. It only lights up the ones that I know for a fact exactly where they are. If these others, see, it's like beeping. There's a artifact somewhere around this area. I have an idea of the general area. I'm starting to move away from it. It's over here somewhere. But see, that one doesn't show up on the map. So, okay. Slight change of plan. I'm going to see if I can. What is the best thing that I need to do? I'm going to put some thought into what is the best thing I need to do with the mapping satellite in order to make certain that it covers. It flies directly over every single square inch of land on the moon. Okay. Here's the deal. I'm looking at the map. It's got my indicator. This tiny little dot there is the path of my vehicle. I'm covering a lot of ground that I've already covered before. It's slightly to one side of the previous orbital path, but not significantly. What my current plan is here, I believe what'll work. I don't want to change the altitude of my orbit. What I want to do is I'm going to wait until I get down here to one of the poles. We'll probably wait to the, and then I'm going to just thrust slightly to one side in order to change the inclination of this orbit just a little bit, and hopefully that'll get us so we'll do a better job of filling in the gaps between some of these stripes. So let's actually slow down. Let's start thinking about this. Okay, there we can see the nav ball spinning around. I mean, that's evidence that I'm actually right at the pole right now. So we'll wait till I'm just barely past it for the nav ball to settle down. No sense in trying to aim it while the thing is like spinning randomly, you know? Except earlier, let me see. I want to get a sense of what direction we're going. Now that's really weird. That just a second ago the track indicator was east-west. Now it's doing this north-south deal. Okay, but we'll just go to sideways a little bit. Farther past the pole than I liked. I wanted to, but this'll still work. Okay, lock it right here. Push just a little bit. Just enough to see it move. Okay. And we'll take a look and see. I don't know. I hope that wasn't a terrible idea. We'll see what that does to my mapping and muon detecting. Yeah, okay. A couple of orbits later, I'm going to say that inclination change that was a qualified, that was a success. That was our little cursor here showing our path is getting into filling in the empty spots better than it was before. Not perfectly better, but you know, I didn't expect to get it perfect. I'm excited about this. Yeah. So we still got this thing going all crazy. We've got I spotted another stone arch over here, I believe. Maybe my eyes are playing tricks on me, but I'm pretty sure I saw one. On the edge of that thing. Oh yeah, there it is. Tiny little dot back there. Okay, but, Harv, Herbert, and Sally, they had a talk with Mission Control, and they they've made the decision that they really are not going to focus on investigating the stone arches at this point. We are looking at other kinds of artifacts at the moment. So, we want to find, especially if they want to find the counterparts of these, of the monolith. This is fun. I really like scanning for these things. Yeah, okay, yeah, this site over here, then the, what's the currently in-shadowed side of the moon? I think I was wrong earlier. I thought it was, might have been around this large valley or canyon that's connected to this crater. I think it's actually a little bit south of that. There's something, like somewhere around there. Just paying pay a little closer attention to exactly where it speeds up. I still can't see anything. At the moment, I'm inclined to go with that. Was my first. That was just my first instinct. You know, it's kind of like taking a test. You always if you don't know what the answer is, just go with your first. The first guess is the best chance of being right. I'm thinking that I might go for a landing somewhere around here. And go investigate whatever might be there. That's the plan right now. But we're going to continue mapping for a little while before committing to that. Haven't actually made that call yet. Hours later. Okay, you can take a look at this map. In-game, we've gone like 3 days here mapping this. We've got the basics roughed out of all of it. I mean, there's still some stripes that we're missing. It's going to take a long time to gradually fill in all the blanks. We still have not really confirmed just like an actual solidly mapped the location of any more of these artifacts. We know the locations of two of them. This is one is that the stone structure, it's the stone arch, and this one we cannot see what it is. I'm hoping it's a monolith. I've talked to Mission Control, and we're of the opinion that we want to go for the stone arch some other time. This mission is going to continue to focus on the monolith. Hopefully, it's a monolith there. This site over here that was looking attractive to me, because I've not been able to confirm its exact location. I mean, I've got a pretty good idea where it is. Not exactly. We haven't mapped it. No, we're not going for that one. At this point, I'm going to start thinking about setting up a landing on the south pole of the moon, very close to the south pole of the moon, in order to see if we can locate the source of the muon emissions. It's somewhere around here. It's not actually on the pole itself. It's somewhere around here. So, yeah, let's take a look at doing that landing. First thing I need to do. Map off. Okay. I'm going to leave the satellite. The independent satellite is going to stay in this orbit that I have right here, right now. It's just not going to change anything. So let's go ahead and decouple. Bang! Done. Decoupled. Okay. Let's see if I can just translate away from that a little bit. There we go. Yep. Okay, for right now, I guess I'll leave that on. I'm thinking at this point, let's go ahead and fold up the solar panels just because I'm expecting to be doing some acceleration and maneuvering and they might not be able to take it. I just made that up just in the spur of the moment. Do I want to, whenever I do my deorbit burn, go ahead and try and swerve around? I think I'm going to do the very careful, conservative way. We're just going to wait and do several more orbits until it lines up, naturally lines up over the spot that I want. Okay, so yeah, fast forward some of that. Yep, I'm thinking that this next time around, see, our satellite has separated from our lander a little bit. Yep, the next time around, we're going to go for the landing. I'm a little bit nervous about it. I haven't really practiced whenever I was not recording. I've done a couple of moon landings, but I haven't really done enough of them to be a consider myself any kind of pro at it, you understand. It's okay, guys. It'll all work out correctly. It'll work out just fine. Nobody needs to worry. What's the worst that could happen? So, let's scoot on up here. And get to about 90 degrees away. And I'll start doing some burning. Just as a guess. Okay, take it back down to times one speed. And let's point this in the correct direction. Center it right about there. Lock it in with SAS and let's go. Yep, we're burning. Stop. Okay. And just a little bit of burn, that made a big change already, huh? And go. Okay, we're committed. Definitely got a landing going this time. I'll go ahead and I'll turn the lights on right now, just so I don't forget about it later on whenever things start getting a little bit hectic. Because where we're going to be landing is in shadow, so that's going to make things a little bit more interesting. The map gave me low resolution, not really great amounts of detail on it, so I am not too incredibly certain of just exactly where, even though it helpfully put a dot for me there. I know it's in this area somewheres. And well, that's why the thing's got wheels. Come to think of it, I should double check this. In testing on Kerbin, if these hinges come in contact with the ground, they explode. Let's make certain we've got those wheels set such that those hinges do not contact the ground, because that would be sad if our legs exploded. Did my Kerbals hear me? Harv heard me. Okay, go back down one. Let's slow that orbit down. Let's change the shape of our arc. In slowing down, I know that my arc, it would come much closer, but I actually want my arc to be further out there, so I'm actually going to point this thing upwards some, like this. Right about there. Yeah, that'll work. Oops, too far. Yeah, we'll try and keep that line pointed right at the pole for right now. And drop my orbital speed down a few hundred meters per second less. So we weren't cooking in there at like half a kilometer per second. Okay, and you aim it a little bit further. Yeah, that's working. Okay, I want to take this down to... Oh, we see. We've actually... Okay, I'm going to stop. I'm going to wait until my arc takes me up there to that apoapsis. And then we'll do some more burning. Let's take a look how much fuel we got. A little more than half a tank. It's almost closer to like two-thirds tank. So that's good. I know it's kind of a long burn, but it's, you know, just one single engine. It's the... That's actually the stock small engine right there. So it's very, very fuel efficient. And it's got four of these tanks to go to work through. So it doesn't burn fast, but it can burn for a long time. Okay, yeah, aim it right about here. I'm trying to burn off some more orbital speed and keeping our same general target area. Let's go. Oops. Oh, hang on. Let's aim it more vertically to get that arc out there where I need it, please. Thank you. Alright, no, I was thinking about it backwards again, wasn't I? Oh, no, I was thinking about it the right way. Oh, I'm screwing this up. Okay, let's go try and aim pure vertical for now. I'm screwing this up, damn it. Let's actually aim it a little bit more in this direction. Oh, did I screw this up just so totally? Oh no, that's aiming downwards. That's the wrong thing to do. Matt, come on, think about what you're doing here. I got confused. I was looking at the wrong mark. Come on. Yeah, that was just stupid. Why did I do it that way? You guys would be cussing me out. I deserve it. That was a really stupid mistake. Oh, that was a really, really stupid mistake. It's my altitude 10,000 and dropping very, very fast. Oh my god, did I just really... Am I going to kill these Kerbals? Oh, I may have just really, really screwed up. Let's try this. I'll burn some of this RCS. Put some extra thrust that way. That's why I've got this heavy-duty RCS on here. Aiming for the right spot is no longer an option because I just totally screwed it up. Now I'm just trying to save my Kerbals. Live, guys, live. Maybe in for a long, long, long drive over the surface. Okay, come on. Surface speed is dropping. This is good. Can we pull out of it? No. No, that ground's coming up too fast. No, no, oh my god, no! Ah! Oh my god, Herbert and Sally. Oh my god. I just totally screwed that up. I just made one stupid mistake on top of another. It's over, it's curtains for them. Sally, no! I can't believe I screwed it up that badly. Oh wow, that was dumb. Okay. Well, we have to do some more planning. Obviously, we don't have to fly an entire Prospector mission back up here, since I'm gonna have to make something just a smaller, simpler lander this next time around. That was disappointing. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Bye.